We are back now and new at 5:30. Today marks the 50th anniversary of Hall Ambulance and its service to our communities. This morning, the president and CEO of the company and Harvey Hall's widow, LaVon Hall, presented the keys to four 50th anniversary Hall Ambulance units to selected EMTs and paramedics. They were chosen for upholding company standards and at times exceeding those standards and the ideals of care, compassion, and community. Plus, to mark the anniversary, employees were presented with a 226-page coffee table book that highlights the company's history, as well as a 50th anniversary lapel pin and a challenge coin.
Well, Hall Ambulance's owner and founder, Harvey Hall, passed away nearly 3 years ago, but he continues to support the community his ambulance company has served for exactly a half a century. Hall's widow, LaVon Hall, administers the foundation named in his honor that has funded a number of community programs and projects. LaVon Hall talked about her foundation work and about her colorful late husband, who also happened to be Bakersfield's longest-serving mayor. Here's 17's Robert Price.
To many, Bakersfield Mayor Harvey Hall was a larger-than-life figure with his broad smile, memorable suits, and outsized personality.
I just love being an ex-driller, and I love being a part of this community.
4 terms he served as mayor, unprecedented in the city's history. So when he left us very suddenly at age 77 on May 19th, 2018, from a rare degenerative brain disease, we lost perhaps the city's most recognizable character. Hall did not live long enough to celebrate the 50th birthday of the ambulance company he founded in February 1971, but his wife of 29 years, LaVon Hall, has made sure he's part of the celebration.
We're very excited to be able to celebrate that milestone. Although it is bittersweet not having Harvey here, he was very excited. Immediately following the 45th anniversary, he started planning for the 50th.
Hall continues to serve the city where he was born and raised with the Harvey L. Hall's Charitable Family Foundation. LaVon Hall administers the community-focused charity.
So a lot of it is just continuing with being able to continue and keep his name involved with organizations and events that he was adamant about.
One of the foundation's priorities is the search for a cure for Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, or CJD, the illness that took his life. The foundation helps fund research.
I'm very proud to have Harvey's name associated with research that maybe someday will find a cure or a treatment or even the cause to CJD.
Harvey Hall saw some striking events during his 47 years at the helm, but nothing like the COVID-19 pandemic. What might he have thought about the way his people in those orange and blue vans have handled the outbreak?
He would have been proud. The management team we have in place, he trained. He taught them, and they have lived up to his standards and his expectations. And so he wouldn't have been surprised at all that they're doing the job that they are.
So Hall Ambulance celebrates 50 years without the man who made it all possible. The best thing the people at the company and the foundation can do is honor his legacy as best they can. In other words, keep carrying on. In Bakersfield, Robert Price, 17 News.
And on that note, this next story is proof that the hardworking men and women at Hall Ambulance indeed keep carrying on. Every day they risk their lives to care for the sick in our community. And if you have an emergency, they are your first point of contact. We are, of course, talking about Hall Ambulance paramedics and EMTs.
But like so many frontline workers during this COVID pandemic, Hall first responders are under a great deal of stress and constantly find themselves in dangerous situations that could expose them to the virus. 17's Eitan Wallace back in studio now. He had the opportunity to ride along with two heroic Hall frontline workers and has this exclusive report. Eitan?
Well, Jim and Tammy, even with all the danger, as you're about to see, Hall Ambulance EMTs and paramedics step up to the plate night after night and through it all, save lives. It's a Friday, just before sundown. As most in the Golden Empire head home for the weekend, Hall Ambulance paramedic Joe Eastwood and EMT Sean Tinnish are just beginning their 12-hour night shift. Their life-saving work has been significantly impacted as coronavirus cases continue to skyrocket and hospitals fill up. The already pressure-heavy job has been under even more stress during this pandemic. Starting with the first cases last spring, Hall, the ambulance provider for roughly 90% of Kern County, did not miss a beat getting ready, quickly gearing up and cleaning every single ambulance during these COVID times.
Going to people's houses, we're going to medical centers, we're going to prisons, we're picking up people anywhere you can imagine.
Overall, the ambulance provider has seen a huge call volume increase. Take just the month of December, for instance. During December 2020, Paul responded to 9,704 calls, roughly 10% more than the previous year. Since the pandemic started, cardiac arrest calls were up 35% and mental health related calls were up 19%. The system is so busy that ambulances are not being sent to less serious calls. Before every employee here at Hall Ambulance begins their shift, first they need to get a screening in that tent where they'll get a symptom check and a temperature check. So did I when I rode along with Eastwood and Tinnish. What can we expect?
What's great about the night shift is you get a wide variety of calls. You know, you can get your gunshot wounds, you can get your car crashes, you get a lot of difficulty breathing calls, and you get just, it's a mix of everything. You know, if it's in the textbook, they're going to throw it at you. So it should be exciting for you to come out.
All right, shall we go?
Let's do it.
Almost immediately, as soon as the shift started.
Now we're responding towards White Lane and Gosford. This one is for an unconscious male.
We make it to a parking lot in Southwest Bakersfield.
He just passed out in this car.
Let me get your vital signs real quick.
Yeah,
that way we can kind of paint a picture. The thing that we're concerned with, you don't remember how you got here.
In the end, the patient, believed to be dehydrated, declined care.
If it gets worse at all, that kind of stuff, seek evaluation pretty quickly. We do a quick report, full vital signs, full physical assessment, make sure that we can rule out anything wrong with his heart, anything like that, and give him the option to either go to the hospital on his own or come with us, and he chose to go on his own.
Within the hour, another call.
There's an 83-year-old female with chest pain.
That is about all we know as we head to the woman's home. There, they meet Bakersfield City fire personnel. In respect for privacy and the law, our cameras stayed outside as Hall and BFD worked on the woman inside. 15 minutes later, they brought her out and put her into the ambulance.
We'll get you down to the hospital.
Once inside, they put a face mask on her, check her vitals, and head to the hospital. Destination, Bakersfield Heart Hospital. Upon arrival, they take her out of the ambulance and into the patient waiting area. That's when our cameras go off to comply with strict filming rules. In this case, the patient had not yet received a bed, but our crew was able to leave early after they called another crew to come in and watch the patient inside the hospital.
As long as the charge nurse inside the hospital okays it, they can take over patient care, and it will free up the paramedic ambulance to go back out and respond to more incidents.
Well, it's just after midnight, but the calls don't stop. In fact, they're coming in. Now we are on our way to a report of someone in need of medical aid.
Specifically, this call is one that has become all too familiar during these COVID times. The call for a possible coronavirus patient.
56.4.
As we arrive, the pair puts on special protective gear.
So right now, since it's a possible coronavirus type call, we have our N95 mask that goes on along with our isolation gown. So this way we just have an additional layer of protection. So I'm trying to do this pretty quick just because we have to get in there.
And you take this seriously, very seriously.
Very. The coronavirus is a very real threat to us.
They carefully approach the patient on the front porch and work to figure out her symptoms.
You got a fever at all? Do you feel like you have chills?
I have the chills.
After a thorough symptom check, Tinnish and Eastwood help the patient to the gurney.
You're okay. We got you.
The patient is loaded into the ambulance. After checking her vital signs, Eastwood gives her a reassuring update.
Your blood pressure's good. Your oxygen level's great. Yeah, I don't see anything crazy jumping out at me.
With that, they're on their way to the hospital. In this case, Adventist Health Bakersfield. After work, Eastwood and Tinnish clean everything in the ambulance, resetting up the gurney and mopping down the floors. After about a half hour, the entire ambulance is wiped down. This emergency vehicle now ready to go back into service.
And we do it for the citizens of Kern County. We don't do it for the recognition. We don't do it for, you know, the parades or any of that kind of stuff or these news stories. I mean, it's just, I come to work every day loving my job, being able to get on the ambulance, go out and help somebody's loved one in a time of crisis.
The benefit is outweighs the risk.
Right.
Knowing that at the end of the day, you helped someone in their worst time of their life, it's worth the risk in my mind.
Now we're told all patients featured in this report were given the care they needed, which goes to show you what Tinnish and Eastwood and all of the first responders do on a daily basis is truly life-saving. Now today, as Hall Ambulance celebrates its 50th anniversary, you can imagine former Bakersfield Mayor Harvey L. Hall is looking down, proud of this service he founded 50 years ago. In studio, Eitan Wallace, 17 News.
Absolutely, and our hats off to those people who do such a difficult job.
You
Thanks,
bet.
Eitan. Well, certain groups of people